Welcome students. In previous class we have studied about axially loaded welded joints. In today's class we will study about axially loaded unsymmetrical joints. As seen in the given diagram, this angle has been welded on the plate by means of two parallel fillet welds. On the top side, the length of the weld is L1, and on the bottom side the length of the weld is L2. A tensile load has been applied on the plate through CG as seen in this view. The load is passing through center of gravity. Let this weld of length L1 lie at a distance of Y1 from CG and this weld lie at a distance of Y2 from CG. We know that when this load has been applied axially to the plate, this weld and this weld, which are along the direction of the force, will experience a shear stress, or this weld will be failing by shear. Also, this total load P will be bared by these two welds. So let us say this weld will bear a load of P1 and this weld will bear a load of P2. Hence, I can write this total load P is equal to P1 plus P2. Let this be equation number 1. As we know that this weld and this weld will be experiencing shear force, hence I can write P1 is equal to the area of this weld, which will be 0.707 into H multiplied by L1. This is area multiplied by shear stress, that is tau. Let this be equation 2. Similarly, for P2 I can write P2 is equal to, that is load is equal to area multiplied by stress. So P2 will be equal to 0.707 multiplied by H multiplied by L2 multiplied by tau. Let this be equation number 3. Technically, what are P1 and P2? P1 and P2 are the resisting force developed on this weld and this weld respectively. So let us draw a free body diagram. If I consider this load to be on the right hand side, I will have the resisting force P1 and P2 acting on the left hand side. To maintain the equilibrium of the body, the moment about CG of both the welds should be 0. Taking the moments of the forces about CG, we will get, this is going anti-clockwise, so it will be P1 multiplied by Y1. Moment of this force P1 will be P1 multiplied by Y1. This force P2 will be making a clockwise movement. Hence, it will be minus of P2 into Y2. P1 into Y1 minus P2 into Y2 is equal to 0. That is, the moment of all the forces about CG should be equal to 0 for equilibrium. From this equation, I will get P1 Y1 is equal to P2 Y2. Let this be equation number 4. Substituting the values of P1 and P2 in equation 4, we will get L1 Y1 is equal to L2 Y2. This is the most important relation for axially loaded unsymmetrical joints. Also, I can write the total length of the weld is equal to L1 plus L2. Let us try to solve a problem on axially loaded unsymmetrical welds. The question says, an ISA 200 by 100 by 10 angle is welded to a steel plate by means of a fillet weld as shown. The angle is subjected to a force of 150 kN. Shear stress permissible is 70 Newton per mm square. Determine the lengths of the weld at top and the bottom. We are also given with the location of the centroid, which is at a distance of 71.8 mm from this bottom edge. This is an ISA angle. ISA is an abbreviation for Indian Standard for Angles. 200 by 100 by 10. This is 200 mm is the length of the longer side, 100 mm is the length of the shorter side, and 10 mm is the thickness. First dimension is the length of longer side, second dimension length of shorter side, and third dimension is the thickness of that angle. Previously we have seen for axially loaded asymmetrical welded joints, the most important relation was L1 Y1 is equal to L2 Y2, where L1 is the length of weld 1, L2 length of weld 2, and Y1 and Y2 are the distances of the respective welds from CG. Substituting the values which are known to us, L1 is unknown. Y1 is the distance from CG to that particular weld. So in this view we can see the distance from CG to this weld will be 200 minus 71.8. So Y1 will be 200 minus 71.8 is equal to L2, I don't know. Y2, distance of CG to weld 2, that is directly given to us as 71.8. So multiplied by 71.8. From this, I will get one equation, that is 128.2 L1 is equal to 71.8 L2. Let this be equation number 1. From the figure, when this load is applied to the angle, it will tend to shear off these two welds. Hence, both this weld will experience a shear force or shear failure. And we also know that this entire load will be taken up by this weld and this weld. Hence, I can write this total load P is equal to P1 plus P2. We have P is equal to P1 plus P2, where P1 and P2 are the load at welds 1 and 2 respectively. I will get L1 plus L2 is equal to 303.09 mm. Solving equation 1 and 3, we will get value of L1 as 108.81 mm and L2 as 194.28 mm. So in the question, we were required to find out the lengths of weld at top and bottom. So the answer is the length of weld at top is 108.81 mm and at bottom is 194.28 mm. Let us have a look at another problem of welded joint with asymmetrical welds. The question says, how much length of a 10 mm fillet weld is required to weld the long side of an ISA angle 150 by 75 by 10 to a steel plate with side welds? A static load of 125 kN acts through the center of gravity, which is 53.2 mm from the short side. The allowable load per mm of weld is 665 newtons. This is the diagram given where there is an angle of side 150 mm, which is longer side, shorter side as 75 mm and thickness as 10 mm. This channel is welded onto this plate by means of two parallel welds, wherein the length of the upper weld, let us say, is L1 and length of the lower weld is L2. The load applied is 125 kN and CG lies at a distance of 53.2 mm from the shorter side. For axially loaded asymmetrical welds, we have relation as L1 Y1 is equal to L2 Y2. Substituting the known values, I will get L1 multiplied by 150 minus 53.2 is equal to L2 multiplied by 53.2. 96.8 L1 is equal to 53.2 L2. Let this be equation 1. In the question, it was given the allowable load per mm of the weld is 665 newton. This means 1 mm of the weld is able to sustain a load of 665 newton. The total load given to us is 125 kilonewton. So first we will find how much length of the weld is required to sustain a load of 125 kilonewton. We are given for 1 mm of weld, it sustains a load of 665 newton. So for how much length it will sustain a load of 125 newtons. So on solving this, I will get the total length of the weld is 187.97 mm. As this is total length of the weld, I can write 187.97 will be equal to L1 plus L2, that is total length of the weld. Let this be equation number 2. Now solving equation 1 and 2 simultaneously, I will get the values of L1 as 66.67 mm. L2 as 121.30 mm. In the question, it was asked how much length of a fillet weld is required to weld a long side of ISA channel. So long side of ISA channel is the top one, hence I will write the answer as L1 is equal to 66.67 mm. This completes the solution.